Hey guys, how's it going? Back again, another review. I know it's been a few days. I said I had some stouts coming up. We're going to get to them now. It's just been a busy few days. Haven't been able to get the videos out. So anyway, let's jump right into this one. This one should be really fun. I'm really excited about this one. This one's been in the fridge for a while now. I've just been kind of waiting for the right moment. And what better time than now, you know? Nothing special going on today. It's just happened to be that day. This is going to be Cookies and Cream Imperial Stout. Another beer from Untitled Art. And this is a collaboration with Angry Chair. Angry Chair's out of Tampa. Tampa Bay. So anyway. Another thing I forgot to mention before with Untitled Art. They, at the bottom here on the can, it always says artist. And from what I've gathered, they always do like collaborations with different artists. I don't know if they're based out of the same city that maybe the brewery is or what. But I guess the artist does all the can art. You know, so they always like their can art. It's cool. You know, it's nothing like crazy, but it's just, they're all different and they all just have this nice color to them. And it's always cool. So, oh shoot, okay, my bad. So this beer comes in at 12% alcohol by volume. This one has a canned-on date of August 23rd. So yeah, all these stouts that I'm getting to, like, apparently came out in, like, the summertime, or, you know, almost fall. But I don't usually drink these type of beers in the summer a lot, so, it's finally kind of cold out here. Today it was in the low 40s. So, perfect time for Imperial Stouts. I was going to see if there's any info here. On Untappd, it has no commercial description. All it says is contains lactose, which makes me happy. I like lactose in beer. Adds to that creaminess and that sweetness. So, what do you guys say we just dive right in? See what this is all about. Excited about the cookies and cream. I'm a huge Oreo fan. Can we say Oreo? They can't say Oreo on the label, but that's what they're going for. An Oreo stout. Let's get this in the glass and see what it has in store. Pouring a nice brown cola-like character. Dang, not much head at all. Which, I mean, 12% kind of expected. So there she be. We got this in the Trogues Tiku glass tonight. Funny thing about this beer, or this glass, I think I've had like one or two Trogues beers. I just don't get them in the area. And, you know, this glass was given to me by somebody. So anyway, so once we get into the glass, there's some small little highlights of some brownish, you know, rubyish hue around the edges of the glass, up in the light. The main body part of the beer, I can't see anything through it, but up to the top and then the bottom, I can see a little bit of a red rubyish or a brown note or character. Anyway, so the head, yeah, as you can see, it's gone. I mean, it's pretty much non-existent. We'll see if we can generate a little bit of a head. I mean, not even half a finger. It's khaki, you know, khaki head. It's, I don't even want to say frothy or soap sudsy. It's nothing. It's just, it's gone. It dissipated so quick. So, yeah, a lot of times the higher ABV beers, you can kind of expect that. It might generate a head up front, but then it goes away pretty quickly. Let's dive in. Let's get our nose in it. Let's see what it smells like here. Yeah, somebody just crushed up Oreos and dropped them into your beer. Nice chocolatey note. Then it's backed up by a lot of sweetness and vanilla. The vanilla is very prominent. And you get the, you really do, you get the black the cracker, you know, the whatever, the chocolate cookie part of it. It smells so much like an Oreo. It's almost got that character to where you've let it sit in your milk for too long when you're eating milk and cookies, and it starts to break off and get that, like, it gets really soft and all that. That's what I'm getting out of this. There's really not much to say about it other than it smells like an Oreo. It smells exactly what they were, you know, like what they were going for. Yeah, it smells like chocolate. It smells sweet. It smells like vanilla. The alcohol is completely hidden. I smell no, you know, there's no sense of any booze to this. We'll see once we get it, you know, in the mouth if it's, you know, got any booziness to it. Let's go. I'm excited. Okay. A little bit more of the Imperial Stout characters on the palate there. Yeah, it's just a very nice Imperial Stout. Very full, you know, medium full body. You know, you get a chocolate character or a little bit of a light roasty note. And then after you swallow it, it feels like, it tastes like I just had an Oreo dipped in some milk. So that's pretty cool. That's one of the things, not to get off on too much of a tangent here, but everything that I've had from Untitled Art, it completely hits the nail on whatever they were advertising on the can. If there's one brewery that I could think of that would, you know, capitalize on these flavors that they're trying to make, it's them. I haven't had a single beer from them that didn't taste like what they were trying to, you know, go for. Like the hazelnut we just had. It was hazelnut for days. Just thinking back, I mean, you know, I've had some of their milkshake IPAs. They've been perfect. You know, their juicy IPAs are great. But, you know, even back to the, if you go back into my reviews, you'll see the one from Yazoo, a collaboration with Yazoo, where they did the fudgesicle. And, man, it was straight chocolate fudgesicle. You know, it was just amazing. And I love that they're doing this, that they're able to capitalize on these things, man. It's a really cool thing. Because a lot of beers will advertise, you know, that it's supposed to taste like a certain thing or whatever, a creme brulee or, you know, whatever it might be. And, you know, you can kind of maybe search for those notes in that beer and you might get them. But Untitled Art is different. You get it with, you know, every beer that they put out, at least in, you know, from my experience, I get what they're going for. And it's awesome stuff. I love it. So anyway, yeah, it's got a medium to full body. Nice fudgy chocolate, even like a brownie character to it. And then it's got that sweetness, that vanilla sweetness on the back end, and also from the lactose. It really complements the body. It really does. This is a very good beer, very well made. I know this is going to get a good rating from me. Let's check the Untappd and Beer Advocate and see what they're giving it. Okay, so Untappd has got it at 4.33. That's with 3,955 check-ins. That is good stuff. That is a solid beer. I don't have any friends that have checked this beer in. I can't wait to, man. This is going to get a good grade from me. And the Beer Advocate has it at a 92, which is outstanding. So, I think it's a little bit better than a 92. You know, I rate my beers off of the Untappd scale. You know, from me, This is knocking on the door of a 4.5. I'm probably going to give it a 4.5. I love that they always can their beers. And for a brewery that's distributing as widely as they are, it's nice, you know, to get that. And, you know, it gives you, it's just everything that they advertise. And I love that. You know, also, Angry Chair. I don't know if I've had any beer from Angry Chair. I've heard that they're great. Maybe, I don't know if it's the collaborations that make these beers so well, or if it's just Untitled Art alone. So whatever it might be, keep doing your thing, Untitled Art. People love your beer. I love your beer. I can't wait to pick some more up. But anyway, yeah, this is getting a 4.5 from me, man. This is really solid stuff. It's an Oreo Imperial Stout. The alcohol is very well hidden. I mean, you get a little bit on, you know, the body that you would expect from a 12% beer. But the alcohol is well hidden. It's just a chocolatey, you know, fudge brownie type sweet, vanilla-like stout. And it's so good. I definitely recommend you picking this up if you haven't. Yeah, 4.5 from me. If you guys have had this beer, please let me know what you think of it. I would love to talk to you guys about it. If you haven't had it, seek it out. Even being, you know, we're almost 4 months in a can, it's still fantastic. None of these characters have, I would be surprised if any of them have fallen off. If it was much bigger than if the notes that I'm picking up in this were bigger, you know, when it was fresh, dude, this would be knocking on the door of a 5 beer for me. This is awesome stuff, guys. Check it out if you haven't. Let me know if you have. Until next time, guys. Cheers.